You know, the most heartbreaking of all dreams, I'll tell you what mine is. And I've dreamed it maybe 3 times in my life, and I hope I die dreaming it. It's so obsessive with me that I talk about it around home with Maxie and Chris and Kevin, my little boy, and so on, which I call the legend of the happy swimming pool. And I'm somewhere in the neighborhood where I grew up in Atlanta, and I go down a street that I've never been on before. I mean, there was no reason ever to go there. And there's a marvelous swimming pool, there's lovely girls, you know, who are crazy about me. I mean, and there's this sense of, where have you been? You know, we've been waiting for you all these years.
Hitchhikers slumped in the back seat. I sneaked a quick look in the mirror. She gave me a smile. I said, is any God. How did they get in here? I thought we were safe home in England, she said. Through closed eyes, I see West German skies on the ceiling. And I wanna get back to the girl with the rucksack to feel her flaxen hair. I wanna be there. See the sun going down behind Krupp's outskirts of some German town. Just say good night. Good night.
Could I have the keys to 143, please? Thank you. Good night.
Fish takes a hook.
Ah. Ah.
understand the music. Yoko, was it all in vain? Vicious, something mystical.
You know this feeling, though,
yeah.
That there's something in your life that you could, all you have to do is turn a corner or open a door, and it'll all be so... I don't fear the nightmare. I can take any nightmare. I fear the dream, which is good, which has the reality that we can't achieve in reality. I fear the end of the happy dream.
He set out in the spring with a trunk full of books about everything. You adopted a fox cub whose mother was somebody's coat. You fed him by hand and then snuggled him down in the grandfather bed while I wrote.
I told the kids stories while you worked your loom, and the sun went down sooner each day.
Chapter 6. Gio has a birthday, gets two presents.
Come on,
Dad. Eeyore, the old grey dog, stood by the side of the street, looked to himself in the mirror. for the first time today. I feel it's really over. You are my everyday excuse for playing deaf, dumb, and blind.
And who'd have ever
thought this was how it would end for you and me? To carry my own millstone out of the trees. And I have to admit, I don't like it a bit being left here beside. Steps in libraries and railway stations and books and banks and the pages of history and suicidal cavalry attacks. I recognize in every stranger's eyes, and in wheelchairs by monuments, and in tube trains, in commuter accidents, in council care and county courts, at Easter fairs and seaside resorts, in drawing rooms and city malls, award-winning photographs of life rafts and the so easy now. As we lie here in the dark, nothing interferes, it's obvious how to beat the tears that threaten to snuff out the smoke of our love.
Fear the nightmare. I fear the end of the happy dream.